All right, back to being verbalist this morning. I actually want to talk about cynical. cynicism. How come some people are able to be the expressant free, you know, like wear their heart literally on their sleeve, and others are so jaded that it is a oh my gosh, you know, I would not dare, you know, that type of organization of clothing. I would feel the fool jested into a naive place. And then, you know, in the backslang, I'm just like, what? Cynic? What a cynic you are, you know, what a cynical person. That you can't play that naive, that open, that available for love's what? Love's heart to even be broken? Yeah. That available, you know. And I go back to like, you know, the teenage years, you know, when you're like really like, well, there's that you know, you wear like your favorite dog or whatever on your chest. You know, and you have all of these clothing with the little hearts sprinkled around everywhere, you know, hearts everywhere. You know, big hopes of hearts and the arrows through, and it's just like this big hope strooming, you know, past. And then at some point it's just like get away, you know. And then there's the other who is non-casual and absolutely abrupt in energy, and showing the broken heart. The broken heart, you know, just on display. Like broken hearts. I mean, how loud and how demanding a human being that is, whether on artwork, whether in clothing, how loud and demanding that I have to see a broken heart. Can't we just pretend? You know, can't we just pretend that doesn't exist? That's just like a, why do we have to deal with it like on a facial recognition moment? You know, it's like, oh gosh, you know, do I have to act away? You know, do I have to act away from it? You know, oh. You know, that moment, you know, and they have that beautiful heart, and then it severs in, you know. Strange, it's a strange, what do you call it, a display? It's a strange display of, now is that a cynic? Is that person a cynic? It's just like a loud one, you know, just forget it. You know, maybe that person is the loud cynic. Just like an exhibitionist of broken heart. Yeah. Does that make the person a cynic or not? Or does that mean the person is just needing mending and just calling across a vast Grand Canyon, mend me, I need help, sew up my heart, you know? Or are they saying everybody else's heart is broken? Everyone else's heart is broken and mine isn't, and I'm able to see that, you know? It could be that. It could be a person that's just making the agony for the rest of us. Could just be an agonizer type, yeah. So he's dangerous. Anybody who wears those types of things is dangerous. Because he could just be an agonizer type, just agonizing know, am I supposed to fix something here? I mean, already I'm like, am I supposed to fix somebody's heart? You know, somebody's broken heart. Yeah, so I don't know. It's a lot of queries, and it does dance around cynicism, doesn't it? The cynic in you, you know, how far is love and naivety allowed? The romance of its aspect, you know, the romance of its fattening. It is a weird word, isn't it? Spect, being speck in German, being the fat of a pig, and then there's aspect there, looking so fat often. Yeah. So there it is. There is a cynicism moment with this heart, and I'm just, you know, and I just wanted to be like free and playful about. Meeting that journey of that gallery moment, but I can't be because it's coming with fix it mementos, and so I don't actually feel allowed. I was gonna just like, I don't know, talk randomly and freely, but now I have cynicism, the chore of cynicism to deal with, and I'm like, well, great. I guess I am a cynic. I guess I'm not naive. I guess I am not romance's heart happy. I guess my cupid is broken. Yeah, my cupid is broken. So there. So I can't really help that gallery. Can't help them. Maybe I'm not a painter at all. You know, it almost seems like a tacky moment, though, doesn't it? Anything to deal with the symbolism of a heart, it just starts to just feel tacky. I'm just going to go down cynicism trail, take that Dorothy way, and yeah, it just starts to feel tacky. So maybe that's it, you know, you break the heart of tacky. Maybe that was this sentiment. Let's just kill the tacky heart romanticism straight away, because it doesn't exist. So it's very possible that the artist himself is trying to say that romanticism is dead, and that it never will live properly. It'll be destroyed. It'll be destroyed by something cynical. So in a way, it's a very, very sad situation. It's a sad situation for the young teenage woman to find, you know, the one who did love that symbolism, love the symbolism of the, you know, the Holly Hubbles. The Holly Hubble dolls, the kiss and quaints, the 50-year love relationships, yeah. So I guess so. I guess I don't have an answer aside from, I don't feel welcome. I don't feel welcome. Anywhere near that heart, either in the shape, form, romance, or broken, painted. In form, I don't feel welcome. I'm that much cynical over you. Yeah.